Hi, everybody, and welcome to a special series on the Busy Dad Workshop channel here. Over the past few videos that I've done, it's all been about DIY, things around the house, things around the yard, and some other things that I've done, and with cars as well. Well, this is a little bit different. We're actually going to build ourselves a new home. This is going to be our forever house. And this particular project is very special to me because we are building it on family property. This is three generations old property. My parents' house is over here, my grandparents' house, and our home will be here on this property. And what I'm going to do in this video is kind of walk you around the property, show you where things are going to be at, and kind of give you an overview of this, what this whole project's going to be about. So with that, let's walk around the property. All right, the first part that we're looking at here is the camera is standing right at the driveway entrance. So the driveway is going to come straight up here. It's going to go back, I think it's about 65 feet, and there's going to be a three-bay garage here with my workshop behind it, and the house is going to go out this direction to the west. And then the way the property goes, if we ever have to do it in the future, is we can do a little driveway around to the side of the garage to go back to the workshop that's back there in the back of the property. So right now the camera is in the corner of the property looking back along the length of the property. So you can see my grandparents' house is over there, and the flat spot here, of course, is where the house is going to be. One thing we have to deal with, though, is this. This is the power line. Right now, as it stands, it's the pole is here in the corner of the property line. It's an overhead line that goes to that pole that you may be able to see back there, and then it drops an overhead line to my grandparents' property, or my grandparents' house. But what we're going to have to do is the power companies are going to have to come in, remove this, go underground here, underground along the front of the property. Somewhere there's going to be a transformer box here. We're not sure where yet, but that's the first thing that has to be done before we can do any kind of digging here, because that droop is only about 25 feet above the ground right over there. All right, so now we are about halfway back the property. This is where we have to start dealing with the septic, because we don't have public sewage or public water here. So we're going to have to sink a well out front, and we're going to have a special a septic system, which I'll talk about in another video, but it has to do a lot with nitrates in the water. And so where that's going to go is basically right here between these trees, between these pine trees and these large trees here. One fun fact is that second tree in here, so you have one and then two, that tree my brother and I, when we were little, built a tree house there. So I'm hoping that in one of these trees that I can build a tree house for my girls as well. All right, now one of the things with building a new house in this particular township is dealing with stormwater management. So what we have to do is we have to capture all the rain that's on property and take care of it on property. So on the driveway that's out front, we have to capture that water, and it's going to have to go into a basin out front. And then all of the roof. So the roof itself is going to be about 114 feet across. Now all that water has to be captured and dealt with on property. So what we're doing is we're going to have a rainwater catchment basin back here behind the building. So back here, and we'll walk back here in a minute, but I'll kind of explain where that's going to go. But from where the house is at, right across down through this swale here, and then down along the building, we're going to have to put a 6-inch pipe all the way across here to the house and across to the back of the house to capture all this water. All right, so now we are standing behind the building. And right here, as I mentioned just a minute ago, is where the rainwater catchment has to go. So because of the surface area that we're covering it with impervious coverage, like I said, that 6-inch pipe has to come all the way down here. Right here, basically, between the building and kind of where these pine trees are here, is that there's going to be a 75-foot by 25-foot by 4-foot deep pit that we're going to have to put 2 feet of aggregate rock and then 2 feet of soil above that. And the whole thing has to be wrapped in geotextile fabric. So all that is gonna be right here. So this all has to be excavated, piping and rock. All right, so I hope you guys enjoyed the quick walk around the property and where things are gonna be placed. There's gonna be a lot more videos coming, so please stay tuned for updates. We're gonna try to do them as regularly as possible. This is going to be a project that probably takes through probably close to December till we get everything done and in place. There's going to be a lot more coming out, a lot more content, very specific content as well, as like with the septic system, the well water system, and all the filtration that we're gonna have to do. So stay tuned. Hope you guys enjoyed this. If you haven't subscribed yet, please subscribe down below, and I'll see you next time.